Good evening.
Welcome to Black Screen. Oh, wait, Black Screen is gone! Anyway, good evening. I'm 89. Welcome to Final Fantasy 15. I guess I'm doing it now. I was thinking about just waiting a little later, but I guess we're doing it. Anyway, notes. I guess I should note a few things. Okay, this is at 65. Playthrough-wise, shit, I messed up. I wanted to do a decent level playthrough because I was ridiculously overpowered in my own, so I want to do it with minimal grindage going on. I want to probably do one of each character's quest thing just to show it off because that's the type of person I am. And, yeah, you're going to be doing pretty low leveled, I guess. And, what else? I don't know if we'll actually be discussing the game a lot. I wanted to. I was thinking about it. There was a lot whirling around in my head, and I was like, okay. But, I don't know. I don't know how it's going to go. But anyway, you saw me turn off the music. There's a reason. And it's going to completely change how you feel about the first scene. It's completely different. In my opinion, it's kind of different. Anyway, let's read this. Final Fantasy 15. In a time unknown, only prophecy keeps hope alive in people's hearts. When darkness veils the world, the King of Light shall come. Blah, blah, blah. Now four brave warriors begin their journey. Prepare to fight. What awaits the four? However, they do not know. Anyway, as I was saying, I don't know. Was I talking about the music? Yeah, you'll know. But when I was doing this again to see if it would actually stop the music, when the first scene played, I was like, holy shit, this feels completely different because there was no music. And I apologize for turning it off, but I have Oh, actually, you can then, but I'd rather turn it off so, you know, those things. Tale of the Chosen King, Savior to the Star, blah, blah, blah. I always say blah, blah, blah. Pardon me. It's a bad habit. Anyway, there's going to be some things I want to note and stuff. I don't know. I really like this game, but I know. I've been seeing people bitching about it and whatnot. He's got some facial hair going on. And his actual hair looks a little different. Yeah, as you can see, there's no music going on, so it seems kind of empty. Feels kind of void, except for the sounds of the flames, I guess. But anyway, here's where you get introduced to the character, Zuh. And, gonna be honest, it's a little bit half-ass. You just kind of see them, and then they get their name and stuff. And are subtitles not on? Also, yeah, I'm playing with the Japanese audio, so that's the thing. Apparently this scene may have some significance later, I'm not sure. I'm only in chapter, like, 9 or something, so I just started it because I was a bit hesitant about it, I wanted to get everything done. But anyway, yeah, that's the end of this. I don't know. There's plenty of stuff that kind of starts like that and then jumps you back. Before the fall, wait, what? Oh, right, yeah. I'll be probably discussing some of the extra material, too, because I've watched it, the anime, Kingsglaive. You know, those things. I know some people might be disappointed about it, but I want to be honest. It really isn't all that important. There are some things that happen, I guess, but I'll get to it. Like, this scene here, it's only mentioned in Kingsglaive, but, you know, it kind of connects, which is kind of nice, but see, in my opinion, Kingsglaive on its own probably wouldn't be all that great, but when you play the game and you see it, it kind of adds to it. Otherwise, it's only like a so-so movie, in my opinion. Too much action scenes, I guess. Not my cup of tea. He sounds different now, or is that just me? Also, I find it funny that they're not using his car, because apparently, like in Kingsglaive, Noctis' car ends up being used by, I forget the guy's name. And he gets completely wrecked! It's pretty funny, I guess. They're using the king's old car, I guess. Whatever his name was.
Yeah,
どうぞそちらもニフルハイム帝国様に失礼のないようにな。
心配などいるものか。
お互い様。
いいか、途中で投げ出すことは許されない。
投げ出すかよ。
Pardon me for silence. I usually, I don't know why, but I find myself trying to listen to it again, even though I've seen it. It's got subtitles and it's Japanese anyway, so I'm sure most people be like, why? I prefer it personally. It's a personal thing. But also, when you see this one character, you might understand better. If you're like me, you'll understand. I'll pretty much... That'll probably be my first character-based rant that I go into, because... as far as the characters that we start with, as far as I'm aware, I've only seen one scene that kind of ties in with the character backstory shit that was in Brotherhood, and that was Prompto's when I kind of rested at one of the hotels. I kind of have a tendency to go to the same place over and over again when I'm resting, so I haven't rested all the motels. I haven't rested all the campsites, so on. But there's scenes and things that occur at each one, so... Well, not necessarily each one, just some of them, I guess. And possibly at certain points in the game. I'm not entirely sure, okay? I have played, 90 hours, and I still don't even know. Most of that was just kind of doing quests, and... I'm still focused on hunts, which is probably one of my biggest... things that I'd complain about. It's not inherently bad, it's just that I don't really like it. Oh god, departure! Prince Noctis sets forth from his homeland with his three-man retinue in tow, his destination, Altissia, capital of Accordo, where he formalized a union of state. Oh god, sorry, I'm reading terribly. Through his marriage to Leluna Freya of the Imperial Province of Denebrea. Anyway, shit, I started reading that, I forgot what I was talking about. Shit, well, whatever. I don't think it matters, probably. Otherwise I wouldn't have stopped and, done that, but yeah. If you know what I was talking about, do remind me later. Or not. Because I'll completely forget. Let me try and process here. Oh, and also, a lot of people complain about the loading screens being long. Almost everyone complains about him in any game with a loading screen that's more than, 5 seconds. I don't think a Theft Auto is way worse for an open-world game. And the world of that is rather bland, lifeless, and not very fun to me. But I really enjoy this in comparison. Also, yeah, this here... You kind of don't get a how-did-this-happen sort of vibe, but if you watch King's Glaive, it happens, after the credits. Apparently Prompto was the one driving. Wouldn't be his fault, I guess, but... But anyway, that's how we end up here. Anyway, this is the part of the game where I'm like, okay, damn it. I thought I had to push X or something, but it's right trigger. And that's kind of my least favorite thing to hold to do things. I mean, it makes sense when you're in a game where you're driving and whatnot, but gonna be honest, for me, I find that almost every controller I've ever used, the triggers are the weakest point, and they're the first to give away. Like the Xbox controllers, the original ones, those gave away a shit ton. I think we've just sold five or so controllers. And then recently our Xbox kicked the bucket. Also the PlayStation, not the PlayStation 3 ones. The Xbox 360 ones, they were pretty bad too, sometimes. The one part that makes this more interesting is the fact that they're having a little chat, but... Because if it was just us pushing it... Which can happen, by the way. Because of... Crap. Because if you run out of gas, you have two options. Either you push the car or you get it towed. I was how far from a town? And I decided I was just gonna push it. Anyway, it's pretty rough. Oh, and according to the actual distance in-game, they didn't get very far. Although then again, from my standpoint, I'm like, okay, the world's clearly been scaled down, so it doesn't take as long to get from place to place. And a lot of the outposts feel less like towns and more like just random, I don't know. Which makes them feel kind of weird, because there's no, like, housing or anything. So... Oh yeah, what's the song that plays here? I forget what it's called. I guess it fits, it's just not my cup of tea when it comes to songs. Maybe just this particular version, I don't know. But anyway, shit. Pushing the car, yeah, that kind of sucks. It's super slow. It costs money to be towed, I guess, but... Refilling your gas is surprisingly cheap, which I find a little bit disappointing. Because early on, you're not going to have a whole lot of money, but once you get to a certain point, yeah. It's a huge hit or miss thing for me. I can't imagine gas being that cheap. The one taking a nap. Or, you know, chilling out. As I was saying, this character here in the English version. Wait, what? Network features? I don't care. And that, like, what the hell? I don't know why they made her, like, southern or whatever. It's just weird to me. That's my biggest complaint with her. I don't even complain about how she dresses, even though it does look kind of dumb. It's more about that. 113. What was... I can't remember what the plate was on. I should start it up again in the background.
Let's see. Huh?
So I don't know if I should go about doing the upgrade quests. Those ones are decent, but if I feel I'm underleveled, I might do them just to get a little XP, but a lot of the other ones are like hit or miss if they're actually useful. But the last one, you get the lights so the demons don't come out. Which is nice. When I initially put them on, it didn't really work nicely, but... Anyway, I guess this is where we're gonna see how long it takes to do what I'm gonna do. I plan on finishing Chapter 2, which... might take longer than I thought it would, because of reasons! And lots of reasons! I absolutely suck. That's a reason enough. Anyway, just want to note this. I don't know, the town music isn't really my cup of tea, or the music in towns. But, I guess I don't mind this music. It's okay. But all of them are like, what's the word? I don't know, but it doesn't really mix well with me. Visit the local tipster to gather information. Okay, she doesn't have anything to say right now. We have some starting equipment, which is nice. We can't actually grab any, can we? Yeah, what's the currency outside of the city? Yeah, that's kind of a thing that, it's funny. I don't know, how to put it. In Final Fantasy games, everywhere you go, guild is kind of the currency, or hasn't always been. I think it's like guild in some of them. Also, I was gonna note that, like, which Final Fantasy games I played, just, you know, for reference. You can kind of get an idea of my thoughts on the series overall based on what games I've played, but I'll get to that. Sorry for looking around, there's just shit lying around. Some of it's actually pretty good. Like the magic flasks. Oh, I forgot to mention that! I want to use magic a lot! I like magic. It's pretty powerful. But, yeah. Shit, what else? Where was I branching from? Yeah, the currency thing, yeah. You know, everywhere throughout the world has different currencies, so... It only makes sense, and it's kind of just a funny little thing. It's not gonna pop up, is it? Oh, yeah. That. We're not gonna check that out. Reasons, I guess. Yeah. I don't know how to approach this, because... Usually, I'm either... crap, what is it? Talking about the game as if no one knows anything about it. Which is more like, I just like to explain it from my own perspective, which is half-assed as shit half the time. It happens. Or kind of just going with it as if people know. I don't know if I have to grab any of these. I probably won't. But yeah, it's kind of a mixed bag. Sometimes I don't, sometimes I do, you can say. I don't know if I'm supposed to grab a hunt. Let me check the quest. Ah, don't have any. Check what out? Ah. Oh yeah, usually when you check these things out, like when they're all like, check this out, they'll say something. Yes. But yeah, crap. That hadn't been a thing originally. I mean, they said that, but I don't think I ever saw that appear. I was playing on 1.0 for the longest freaking time until like a week or so ago, and then I got the update. I was like, holy shit! Improved some shit and stuff. It's just cool. Oh, I got a zip for money. What? Yeah, I know. It sucks. Because the tank controls, I was going to mention this when I actually got to him, but now it's not. It's like directional, which kind of feels weird to me, but I feel like I had more control. Like, I don't know. How you'd actually control an animal or something. I've ridden horses before, but don't tell anyone. They're kind of crazy. Ask for a loan. Ask my friends. I don't know. I'll ask for a discount, I guess. I don't remember what I did. I think I asked for my friends last time. But anyway, yeah, I keep branching off. That's something I end up doing, and I end up like just chopping, and I end up forgetting. Forgetting what I was talking about. It's a problem. But yeah, I was gonna talk about Final Fantasy games that I played, because, you know, it's not very many. I haven't really played a whole lot. Reduces MP cost of phasing. Oh, yeah, I want the. Wait, what? Ah, magic! Absorb more. Power craft. But anyway, shit, what was I talking about? I always do this. That's right, I was talking about Final Fantasy games I played. So, should I go in chronological order? Like, because I played the first one, but I didn't get very far in it because I suck. I played the second one, I think. Maybe that was the fourth one. Which one's the one with the... that Dark Knight character? Oh, he's not a Dark Knight, is he? Ah, crap. What is he considered? Yeah, I can't remember. Crap, how come I can't remember? What type of character was he? Something. Yeah, but I think... or was it... that might have been the fourth one. That's probably the fourth one. I think I saw... some for that. But anyway, yeah. I played through the third one, you know, the actual third one. All the way through. It was the remake on the DS or something. God, you know what? I should just go like this. Left button. And it's pretty good. Ah, shit, whoops. There's some good music on there. I can't remember where or when. What was that scene? It's pretty cool. It's like after the first segment and I completely forgot what the music is called, because I guess it isn't really labeled. I wish it was, because I really like that music. Kind of want to go back and play just for that. But anyway, shit. After that, which one? I haven't played the fifth one then, have I? The sixth one I've played, I only got up to the part where... you have to protect Terra on the... is it a mountaintop? I don't remember. I think it took me a few tries to do that. But, yeah. I also didn't get very far in the 7th one, though I played that. I don't know. I didn't do very good at it. I was like, okay. It's the same old mechanics. Push A to flight. I don't know. I just didn't enjoy it as much. 8th game, I've seen like a few seconds of it. Or was it the 9th one? I don't know. I played some of the 10th one. I have like the HD remaster shenanigans. I don't know hell I'm doing when I started that. I was like, holy shit, there's so much stuff, what do I do? And I kind of just started it, and then I haven't played it since. I wish I'd gotten it for the PlayStation 4, but I found it in a discount bin for the PlayStation 3, and I'm trying to talk too fast, why the hell am I doing this? Yeah. And as far as the games go after that, I've touched 13. I have it somewhere. But, defends against attacks. But I haven't really played it, and my Xbox is dead, so... Are you gonna attack me? I'm supposed to defend! I did defend, right? Yeah, so... Yeah, 15, I guess, after that. Obviously, I haven't played any of the MMO ones, because... You know. I'm also just... Oh, did the timer go over, or did I finish? Okay, I must have finished. So, yeah. You know, I haven't really played a whole lot. Especially in recent years. Years may not be the rest... The best. Oh, I'm out of the energies. I'm so used to having so much mana that I forget how little you had when you started out. It's actually kind of rough, starting out. Which I kind of liked, but then it kind of got a little too easy. Once you got to the rest of the world and there's a bunch of side quests... But anyway, shit. Shrite! Yeah, so I haven't really played a lot of Final Fantasy games for lore and stuff, I guess. A lot of people are all like, oh, blah, blah, blah. I don't know about a lot of people. I just read one person saying it and I end up saying a lot of people. Because clearly if one person has that opinion, there's got to be more. There's always more. And then there's people whose opinions are shaped by others. Disappointing individuals, am I right? Ooh, I remember this music. I like it. I don't know if music really plays when you're in the wild a lot. I usually use the MP3 player on my own MP3 player, so... I do that a little too often when I'm playing... Oh god, I can only, like, warp strike twice. Warp strike. Damn, I literally just did that! Land a warp strike! There, did it! That was the worst warp strike ever. Oh shit, what the hell? Also, yeah, combat. Let's talk about that since I want to, like, explore and, you know, think about, discuss stuff. How's the combat feel, right? I don't know, I like it. It's something. It's pretty good. It's a bit different from what I'm used to, because I'm playing Chrono Trigger, and, you know, turn-based stuff. It has a weight system, and I do want to try it out at some point. But as far as the playthrough goes, I'm probably not going to do it because of, you know, blatant reasons that would slow the game down a lot. But I'm considering it at some point. It does seem like it'd be very useful early on, or like fighting enemies at lower levels. You have more control over the battlefield and whatnot, but... Initially, I was like, oh crap, these controls, square for block, circle for attack. It was a bit weird for me, but I've gotten the hang of it. It's pretty nice. Oh yeah, Dave. Dave's got a lot of side quests for us. We'll get to it once we get to it. How does this story arc end? I don't remember, but once you finish, there's like usually a decent scene where you kind of learn about the character. It's kind of nice. It makes him more than just a minor character, I guess you could say. I don't know. That's about all I can say right now. We'll get to talking about it once we start getting some of them side quests. I'll probably discuss them when we get to them. Because I have my thoughts in regards to each type and whatnot. Usually there's enough difference between them that, you know, you're like, okay, it's cool. But some of them, in particular hunts, which are basically like the same thing. Like, oh, go over here! It's monsters! Kill them! Which I suppose I have mixed feelings about. It's not terrible, it's just not the most fun all the time. Especially when there's like timed ones. Originally there wasn't the ability to just make it night or whatever. But now you can do that. Also the rain ones, my least favorite. But I didn't manage to do those ones. Probably not. The car is shot now. We'll never use it again. Let's check this out, shall we? But yeah, side quests. There's a decent amount. Mutant dual horn sided, codename Bloodhorn. Characteristics: red tusks, extremely violent. Standing bounty on saber tusks in the area. Look out! Don't read when there's monsters about. But, we'll get to discussing those once we actually get to them. Maybe I'll just do chapter one and just move on later. Yeah, I don't know why I was thinking about doing... kind of all over the place sometimes. I don't know if I'll be able to manage it. I mean, I could, but I'd take for freaking ever, right? And there's a lot of shit going on, surprisingly enough. Early on, anyway, like, after it, it's kind of like, not quite. Because Chapter 3, once you get the Royal Arm, it's kind of rushed. And you're kind of stuck, you know, doing the main quest after that, so... Usually I would get all the side quests done, that's the type of person I am, and it's kind of what I did, but... I was kind of overleveled a lot, so... Ah, there's a shack over there. Yeah, you know, something that might actually be able to withstand the might of a giant Look at this thing! Look at this building! You can just sneak right through this hole and be like, "Wah! Gobble, gobble, gobble!" and eat someone up. Monsters make gobble sounds, right? That's not chickens or turkeys. I'll fucking know. But yeah, good times. Chickens, turkeys. Oh, look, hey, monsters! Break the target's appendage. I'm not exactly sure what this does. Really. I don't know. Although I can note that it might have something to do with drops. Also, I hate when I use a warp strike and I miss. That really sucks! Especially early on. Can I go up there? Ah, I can't! Dang it. I'm not gonna break your appendage today, sir. Looks like he's dead. Whoops. What am I talking about now? Questings, yeah, we'll talk about that. We'll get to it. There's kind of their own style for each quest, but... Generally, you'll see circles like this, and usually, I'll point out when or why. I kind of dislike those when you're, like, search-finding for stuff. There's a particular quest where we're gonna have to do that, and... I'm probably gonna complain about it! Even though I've done it, I probably won't remember where the stuff is nicely. And this guy's Dave, apparently. Yeah, I've been looking for you. What the hell are you doing hanging out in a shack? I sprained my ankle, apparently. As a side note, that actually really sucks. My ankle still hurts sometimes. It really sucks too, because until recently, I'd never hurt them before, and then... sprained the one, and then the next year, almost exactly a year from it, I sprained the other. Going down a set of stairs, no less. It really sucked. Do it for free. Yeah, it really sucked. The thing was, I was like working out in a field too the first time, so I was like walking and it fucking hurt like a bitch. It sucked. It really sucked, let me tell you. Ooh, magic flask. Do we have two now? I guess I could make some magic. It wouldn't be very powerful, but... I like using it. I like using some magic. Actually, are there any campsites nearby? Oh, yep, there is. Target's up there. Fuck it, we're going to the campsite. We need magic. You'll see exactly how I go about making magic once we get there. Sup, Ignis? Where do you think I'm going? To a campground? Formidable foe awaits. Good idea. I'm not gonna really care about, you know, XP bonuses early on. I'm not exactly sure how high level they'll have to be. Also, I've got the Masamune, or whatever it's called, which is considerably stronger, especially early on, so... Yeah, I know, I'm trying to absorb the magic! I don't remember this. I don't remember talking about this. Also, probably to note that too, like with version 1.0, there's a bunch of scenes that weren't in it and they added in. And I know how people are, they bitch about that sort of thing, where it's like, oh, it should have been in the game initially. You should just be happy they're adding it, especially with the way gaming industry is now and stuff. I don't know a whole lot about it, but I am familiar with certain aspects to a degree because of a weak-ass business course and a basic understanding. But yeah, you know, it's not exactly pleasant being, whatever! Having to, you know, deal with that crap. I honestly don't know what I'm talking about anymore, but you know, you can kind of get just what I'm saying, maybe. Basically, shit, this stuff's garbage. I could equip this. Yeah, sure, why not? Because, you know, they have, like, forced release dates on their games and shit, so they're often... Yeah, the game's often not finished. Basically what I'm trying to say, and a lot of people have a tendency to bitch about that when that happens, but it's quite common in this day and age, you know? Where, you know, day one patches that add and shit. Because, you know, they have to get the games ready to ship out. So, you know, at least they have patches for when they actually, you know, day one, I don't fucking know. But, you know, also the combat grading has changed. Initially it was like offense, defense, and something else. I forget, but now it's like time, finesse, and offense. So, you know, it's different. I don't know how I feel about it because time's kind of a bit of a gray area, in my opinion. But yeah, it's cool. It's nice, I guess. I don't know if that has anything to do with how much experience you get out of it, but... Speaking of experience, magic is the best way to get it. If you have, like, a bunch of rare coins or whatever. One of the guides I was reading was like, just sell it! Sell it all! Except for, like, one or two things where it's like, this is needed for upgrading! So keep it for upgrading. Yeah, we'll use this for now. So yeah, it's kind of like, oh god, what the hell, man? I keep all this shit. Unless, I don't know, I have a shit ton of it, or I know that it doesn't actually help with magic. Some of them just do quality enhancements, so... You know. Well, we'll get to that. Rare coins are probably one of my favorites, but a lot of the lower grade ones that only give you, like, 1 or 4 points, actually, into the specific field or whatever, like... Let me explain this better, okay? You know how it stopped time on that one? I guess you might have seen it. The levels go up to 99, I believe. And after a certain point, you start getting more casts and whatnot as well, which is really useful. That's kind of nice, I guess. So yeah, it's kind of nice just using a lot, especially with the ones that are lower, because as you go up and up and up, your casts will increase. I believe I got like a 99 XP one with like 12 or so casts, which is a shit ton. It's quite nice, to say the least. That's probably one of the reasons I like magic a lot, because if you get one that's at that level, I think it'll give you like almost 20,000 experience maybe on its own. Maybe not that much, but it'll give you a lot. Which is even pretty good late game, so yeah. I don't know about late game, I'm only like mid, but my levels are like 70 or something. It's not too great, but every bit counts, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So you know. Just another reason to use magic, in my opinion. There's only like one major downside with it. You don't get any stat bonuses from weapons equipped. Which isn't a huge qualm for me, I don't really care. I usually fight as is. I pick a weapon if it's the strongest, that's basically it. I mean, some of them have nice bonuses and whatnot, but... Because for me, I was like, okay, whatever. But now I'm just using the ultimate sword, or ultima sword, and like two royal arms and magic. Ooh, nice music change. Just chill out back here so he doesn't notice us. But yeah, that's right. Stealth was one of the things. Which is like blindsiding and whatnot. Which really sucked. Ooh, nice little scene. Yeah, I forgot about this. Was I saying anything important? Probably not. You know, if he's capable of doing that, then don't you think it'd be kind of toasty? If he's lost his cool little side of his head or something. Where was that? Where did he get shot? I wasn't paying enough attention, actually. I don't know why I always use Ignis's now, I just kind of prefer his. Obviously, each character has their own unique ability. I guess Gladios is kind of tank. We'll probably get to discussing that more at some point, but for now, I'm just kind of trying to get the basic shit that I was trying to talk about out of the way, and it's not going over so good. And I'm also sucking because a lot of the abilities I have have kind of just been half-assing now. Wait, Tempest, what? Oh shit, what? I'm supposed to use Tempest? No! Hey, hold still for me. Oh god. But yeah, shit. I was talking about combat at one point, wasn't I? I mean, technically you can probably just hold the O button and, you know, you'd be fine. Because sometimes Noxus will, like, evade on his own or whatever, so... Good job missing! Oh, follow his lead. Okay, that's all I had to do. Okay, cool. I almost fucked it up. But yeah. But yeah, there's a decent enough to it that it's interesting. Like, you know, you have evasion, you got your warp striking. I guess each weapon has its only, like, attack stuff too going on, so... Finding out your favorites! That's how I play anyway. I don't care about weaknesses or strengths. If my damage is doing purple, I'm like, whatever, man. I'm gonna keep hammering this guy until he dies. But yeah. I usually use a sword because none of the other teammates can use it, you know? That's my basic strategy. Yeah, it's just me. Especially with the weight system, I guess you can utilize that better. Yeah, that's also something I'm kind of like, why can't you, like, customize that, you know? Or, you know, it changes or something. Everyone sits in the same place, and when you're driving as Noctis, Ignis just kind of switches place with him. Whereas, like, in Brotherhood, and at the end of Kingsglaive, you know, they're different. And also, as a side note, you can do this now. 1.0, I don't think you could do that. Just warp striking as you're traveling. I like that as a travel method, but right now I can't do it. But anyway, yeah, I don't see why you can't, like, customize it a little bit. Otherwise, it's pretty much all the same. Oh, yeah, right, this giant chicken thing. I think I actually fought this guy recently. I think he's on top of that mountain rock of something place. I think so, anyway. I don't know why he's here. Or it's here, I guess. I also took one of its eggs for one of the quests. I think that was like Gladio's, like, the egg. Not the egg, the ramen one. That was a fun little quest. What was I talking about again? I think I was talking about combat at some point. I lose track of things too fast because I just kind of stop and focus on the game. And my brain is just like, bye bye, have fun, have a nice day. And it just, like, disappears. But yeah, combat, I don't know how some people feel about it. I definitely enjoy it. It's solid. It's all a good time. I'm kind of overpowered right now, so I kind of just hammer warp strike everything until it's dead because I get AP out of it. I don't know where that is. Is that, like, a branch I have to choose, or is that something you start with? I don't know. But yeah. I don't know, there's a guide I was reading that was like, oh, choose these, because the AP helps, and it's like 1 or 2 AP, and I'm like, God, no, it doesn't matter to me! Because I could get a bunch anyway, so... So I don't know what I'm talking about now. Should be fun, right? Dude, we're here on a quest, no... no rest for the wicked, as it were. Also, one of the qualms I had with it is a lot. At certain points, there's like the same dialogue over and over again. Like, whenever I stop in the one town, they always have the same thing to say. Basically, it's a little sad. It's not a huge deal, I guess, but it'd be nice if there's a little bit of variety between them, like, oh, someone else responds to Noctis complaining about how hot it is. You know, just something like that. It's almost always Gladius. He's like, brah, 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 why don't you take your coat off or whatever? I'm like, it decreases your HP count. That sucks early on. Yes, let's do that. Yeah, you hold the camera. We don't have the stand right now. I left it in the trunk. It's locked right now. Also, I was going to discuss how awesome, like, the magic that the royal family has, or Noctis in particular. I don't know. wait, what? Would you all mind? Oh, right, goddammit, the accent. Sure. See, that's why I was complaining about the accent. I was like, ah, God. The Japanese, there's like nothing. It's like so normal that feels weird reading that. I mean, there might be a slight thing to it, I don't know, but just having that accent is kind of like bah. Sure, why not? Also, this is something to note because I don't remember when it happens, but like once you get strong enough to defeat the like Iron Giants or whatever, which are like level 30 or something, then Ignis will drive at night, which is nice because I am lazy as shit. Do you want to drive? No, you can drive. Where are we going? I don't remember where this is. Also, something nice that happened here was like, you can now do this. There's also a shop. I don't remember when this is added because obviously I only had 1.0 and then the cursor very much, but. Ah, there's subtitles. Dude, it's like a few feet away from the city. Also, something to note early on is like your gas is like really limited. Because, let's see, early on you got like, look how fast that gas is draining. But there's two power, not power ups, there's two power ups! I don't know what I'm talking about. There's two upgrades you can get, one that increases your tank size, it doubles it, and one of them that increases your fuel efficiency, like, what, cuts it in half or something? So it barely drains at all, which is nice. I can understand why you'd, what's the word, need a fill-up whenever you get the chance, but once you get those upgrades, it's not even a problem. You know, I don't know if I'll be able to do this. I might have to stop because I'm kind of losing steam. Which kind of sucks. Because I did go for like, what, 3 hours at one point? He just will not drive while the demons are out. Yeah, I mentioned that before. Once you're like level 30 something, he'll be okay. What's up, man? Oh, man. You'll take it out of the trunk. But that thing's locked! That's where I store all my weapons. So I can teleport into my hand. That's one of the stupid things I came up with, and that's... It's mentioned what happens, but I'm like... How exactly? Oh yeah, the dog? I guess he has a pouch for a book? A diary? A journal thing? I don't know what it's supposed to be. How many scenes are there like this anyway? I think I've only seen like two. Possibly three.
お帰りになる時この手帳もお持ちになってもらえませんか。そしてよかったらノクティス様にも何か貼ってほしいのです。
How am I supposed to send it back? I can't fly, teleport places. Crap, I had something to say and I completely forgot. finally going to see after these years, all these years, just left the city. Okay, I'll go with the top one. I always feel like the top one's the best. A lot of the choices, the top one feels like the best. I know there's obvious reasons, because it's time, and you're like, ah, shit, I forgot, I wasn't paying attention, and it just kind of skips. That way you don't really have to feel bad about what it's chosen. It's usually a good option. But yeah, that's right. I also was like, I don't know, hit or miss for the English voice of Luna Freya. I was like, what? I don't know. Something about the accent was like, doesn't feel quite right to me. And maybe she just didn't sound like a child during that scene or something. I don't know. Is there anything important around here? I don't think so. Anyway, let's talk to people. There's a quest. Just a quest. I don't know what I was trying to say there. I am not a customer. There's a quest thing here, isn't there? No, we're good. Thanks. Oh, what? Is it up top? Is it behind it? What's going on? Can I get up there? Now I'm going to be wandering around what the hell's going on. It's been too long since I played. Don't do that, Noct. What the hell? There's got to be a way up. There has to be. That quest is important, right? Actually, it's telling me to go somewhere else, so I get it's probably just a side quest. I don't remember this. Or is this Dave? This might be Dave. Yeah. Why is it over there then? I can't go. You know what? We're gonna just rest here. I don't know how much XP I got. Oh, 300. Let's rest. Oh man, early on, 300 is kind of a lot of money. It's fine though. It's fine. I don't even care, man. It's not a problem, dude. I don't know. I'm talking like this, eh? Bam, 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 bam. Getting a couple levels early on is kind of nice. Eating, blah blah blah. Probably not gonna save a lot of pictures. Unless I'm like, oh, it's good. Like, you know, it's like a one-shot or whatever. You see me picking up shit, what the hell? Also, the dog's kind of cool. Let's keep that. Oh, this one's good, too. Because I kind of maxed it out even when they, like, shrunk the size and gave you, like, twice as much space. I still kind of filled up really fast. I was kind of sad about that initially. I was like, no, it doesn't take up the... Okay. What, also, wasn't there supposed to be a scene? Fine, whatever, I don't even care. We're good. We're probably just gonna head to the destination and call it there, right? I don't know where we're going, though, so... I swear that Dave guy was supposed to be here, and he's supposed to give us a quest. I guess we can talk about his... Oh! You know what? I like when Noctis does his Ignis, kind of like annoyed voice. I played with the Japanese voiceovers the entire time. They're quite good. I prefer them. I don't know how it is with the English one, so. La la la. Might as well grab these. I don't really care for that, so we'll just leave it. Ah, the second one. I don't know why I bought that. Actually, why did I do that? Crap. But anyway, Schmike. Was it happening, man? Oh yeah, the stopping. I don't know. It's kind of fun. I enjoy doing it. Also, put the top on, because it's fun. I like the first person view. Why? Okay, we're going over here. Okay, cool. I was wondering what's going on. Unfortunately, my field of view is rather limited here. Yeah, I can't even see Noctis with this view nicely. Also, the car's really slow. Hmm. 80. 80 kilometers. Pardon me, excuse me.
Luna Freena-sama は望まれてのことらしい。進路も文句はねえんだろ?
Yeah, this thing goes like, what, 50 miles per hour? I'm always to kilometers though, so it's kind of weird being like kind of forced into this. It's not like you have a choice, like you can go, okay, which unit of measurement do I want to use? You can't do that. I mean, it shows how fast it goes in kilometers, but yeah, it's only going 50. There's an upgrade that you get for a quest that makes it go 60, or do you have to buy it? And then there's one that makes you go 70, but that one... That one, I don't know if I'll be able to get that. Unless I had like enough currency, which seems improbable. Because I absolutely suck at that gambling in the arena. Probably get to talk about when we get there, but... Anyway, this is going a lot slower than I expected, but I guess that's to be expected. I forgot how weak you were early on. Kind of sucks. I guess I'll go run over there and get some magic energy and just head back and save, and we'll call it. I pushed A to park. Oh, he's going to park. I forgot. Reverse. That's the way to do it. I always hear people complaining when they're in parking lots, but it's your own fault. If you're gonna drive in because it's convenient, don't bitch about having to back out. It's your own fault, sir. Or ma'am. That is all I have to say on the matter. Anyway, I guess I can go fishing too. Do I have enough time? No, it's gonna take a few seconds to get over there. There are a few things I can pick up on the way, but I don't care! I just want to go get some magic. I could do it off screen, but... I don't know how I feel about doing stuff off screen. I don't know if that's something I really want to do very much of. Unless I like really need a grind or something. I'm not sure though. We'll have to see. But for now, we should be okay. You guys are level 4 and we're like, what, level 3? So we should be okay. For now. Also I don't usually use greatswords because they're super freaking slow. But this one in particular has a nice little ability. Where you have a chance of doing some pretty sweet damage for your first hit. I mean, like if a guy's at full health or something. I don't know. Okay, there's a mining thing there. It doesn't really matter unless I wanted some money or, you know, paint. I don't need paint. The car as it is. It changed everything to purple on mine because it looked cool, but that was about it. It's not a huge deal. Should be fine, I think. But yeah, I guess we're gonna head back and call it. Put some more thought into the next part. Actually think about it a little bit. It's been a couple days since I actually was thinking about that. Like, 4, maybe 5 days. I've been distracted. Like, until yesterday, it's been like 2 or 3 days since I even played, so... This was a little weird, just being all like, okay. Let's do this playthrough now. See what we can do. Because I played Crimson Land before this, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna wait. So I can get the DLC and whatnot, but... It didn't end up working out like that. I just decided to do it. Because what the heck, why not? Ah, I can't switch weapons. I guess we'll start out with fishing though, because I want to... No, I guess we can do that once we actually grab the quest. Because I want to do that quest. I think it's like the first side quest that actually pops up. Besides maybe that one. I think there's only 2 relating to that cat. I'll probably discuss it next time if I can remember. So, this guy's actually at the shop. He wasn't here last time. Like, he wasn't here last time. 5. I don't remember 5, but we'll get it. But anyway, we're gonna stop here. So I guess, if anyone was crazy enough to watch this, which is almost an hour at this point. Thanks, I guess. Until we do the next part, I guess, sometime eventually, good night to you, sirs. Or ma'ams. I'm not gonna judge. But anyway, good night, goodbye, etc., etc. Finishing, I don't know. Let's check out that over there. Whatever. Bye.